After the mono hybrid class, he conducted the dihybrid class, that is, and explained in the form of two gene inheritance or dihybrid cross. What is dihybrid cross? Dihybrid cross indicates here two genes are involved in the cross that resulted to few types of the progeny. So the progeny interpretation given the results of dihybrid crosses. So for his crosses, he selected the characters of two. What are the characters he selected? Yellow, round, wrinkled, green, tinkled, green. So already in previous classes I said, so what are the parental character? Parents are purely homozygous, it means they are pure lines. So that's why yellow is indicated as capital Y. So round is indicated as capital R. Wrinkled is indicated as small r. Green is indicated as small y characters. It means these are the four characters represented in the pea plant, but these are contrast character. For his dihybridization experiment, he selected. So how the experiment is conducted means, first selection of parents. So what are the parent he selected? So first you take the female parent that consists the character of yellow and round. It means here the round and yellow character both are dominant character. You start from round, yellow and round. So capital Y, capital R. And one of the parents is wrinkled green. So round, yellow, capital R, capital Y. A wrinkled green. So it considered as small y. And what type of flower consisting plant it is? It is staminated flower consisting plant. It means considered as male. Okay. So what are the gametes are produced during gametogenesis? So during gametogenesis here, the selected traits are two. Two traits are selected. What are the two traits? One is the color of the seed, another one is the shape of the seed. So one is dominant, another one is recessive. So here from capital R, capital Y, here one gamete is produced. The gamete is composed of character of capital R, capital Y, and here the small r, small y. Okay, so during the fertilization, here during the syngamy, so that resulted into the formation of zygote. The zygote is formed. The formed plant is consisting the character of yellow and round yellow. So what are the characters shown by the progeny means? One of the parental character shown by the progeny. You see here, what is the dominant character that can shown by the progeny here? So what type of the progeny is it? It is a heterozygous progeny and also called as hybrid. Okay, so what is this? Filial generation 1, F1 generation. So for F2 generation, he conducted the self-pollination. So intercrosses he conducted F1 into F1. One is considered as a female, another one is considered as male. Okay. And what are the F1 here? Capital R, small r, capital Y, small y is crossed with capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So what are the gametes are come from? These two means capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Four types of the gametes are resulted. Okay, these are the four types of gametes. From here also, the four type of the gametes, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. Four types of the gametes are resulted. And what are the progeny are produced? We check into the checkerboard. So the gametes are from F1, FN crosses, gametes are capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Okay, and capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Okay, so the resulted of progeny we observe in the Punnett square or checkerboard. So this is the Punnett square boxes or checkerboard. Here female, male. So the female plant produced gametes are capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. And here capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Okay, so the cross between the capital R and capital Y that resulted to capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Here capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, and capital R, capital small r, capital Y, capital Y. So capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So these all are round yellow plants. Round yellow. Round yellow. And in the next row, capital R, capital Y. So capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y. So capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. It's also round yellow progeny. And capital R, capital R, small y, small y. Round green progeny. And capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Round yellow progeny again. And here, next, capital R, small r, small y, small y. So capital R, small r, that represented as round, and small y, green. And next, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. So they are round and yellow again. And next, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Capital Y, small y. So they are also round and yellow progeny. And next, capital R, small r, sorry, small r, capital Y, capital Y. So smaller indicate the character of wrinkled green. Next, smaller capital Y, small y, sorry, wrinkled yellow here, wrinkled yellow because capital Y, capital Y. Here, wrinkled green but heterozygous green, heterozygous yellow. Okay. And next, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. It is also round and yellow. And capital R, small r, small y, small y. So here, round and green. Round and green. And small r, capital Y, small y. Small r indicate wrinkled yellow. Yellow. And next, finally, small r, small y. So it represented as wrinkled green. Like, out of 16 progeny, different types of progenies are produced. So we find the phenotypes and genotypes. How many phenotypes are produced here? 4 types of phenotypes are produced due to the dihybrid cross. What are the phenotypes? The first phenotype is, so morphologically variated phenotypes are, first is round and yellow, either homozygous or heterozygous. And next are round green. Next are wrinkled yellow. Next are wrinkled green. Green. Now you can count round and yellow how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Totally 9. Round yellows are 9. Round green are how many? 1, 2 and 3. So they are 3. Wrinkled yellows are how many? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So they are 3. And wrinkled green are how many? 1. So it means morphologically variated phenotypes are 4. The phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross is right as 9:3:3:1. What about genotypic ratio? So the genotypes are again variated here. So genotypes, how they are represented? So you see here, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small y, small y. You write lines. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R, small y, small y. And capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, small y, small y. And another one, small r, capital Y, capital Y, small r, capital Y, small y, small r, small y, small y. So, how many phenotypically variated progeny? You see here, how many capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. How many you see here? This is the only one, round and yellow. So that is capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So how many? So that is 1. And next, capital R, capital Y, small y. It means here, the Y represented gene is heterozygous gene. So it means yellow coloring gene. So that is heterozygous, capital R, capital Y, small y. How many? Totally 2. Next, capital R, small y, how many? Only 1. And capital R, small r, capital Y, they are 2. Capital R, small y, they are 4. And capital R, small y, they are 2. So according to table. So according to result. So smaller, smaller, capital Y, how many? 1. So smaller, smaller, capital Y, small y, how many? 2. So genotype of final one, smaller, smaller, small y, how many? 1. So totally 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9. 9 progeny, it means 9 genotypic variations are found. So they are in the ratio of 1:1, 2:4:2, and 1:2:1. So that's why the dihybrid cross, the phenotypic ratio or phenotype ratio is called, is right as 9:3:3:1. So genotype ratio is right as 1:2:1:2:4:2:1:2:1.